How's that for an opening? How you doing, guys? If you didn't know what that's from, that is from the miniseries that was on HBO. It's executive produced by Tom Hanks, From the Earth to the Moon. A chronicle of basically, it basically covers the entire American space program, but it mainly focuses on Apollo and the Apollo flights to the moon. If you've never seen that miniseries, and you have any interest in space at all, I highly cannot, I cannot recommend enough seeing it. It's an excellent miniseries. It's very factually accurate. They really did their research for it. It's an excellent miniseries. So I highly recommend it, From the Earth to the Moon. It should be out on DVD. I don't even know when, I don't know if it's out on Blu-ray, but I have a very old DVD copy of it. So highly recommend it. Get it, watch it, appreciate it, and think, why the hell are we not in, were we not in space right now and hitching rides on other people's rockets? So, evening, everybody. Welcome. Little different thing to going on tonight. Usually I'll have Star Trek Saturday Night in about an hour and 15 minutes, but I'm really tired from my 12-hour stream yesterday. So I'm not doing Star Trek Saturday Night tonight, and I'm doing Kerbal right now. It's late night Kerbal, but it's an early edition of it. We're not doing it late. I don't think I'll be on a long, long time, but I'm on for a while. I've got a couple things I want to design, a couple things I want to work on, and I just had the feeling like I wanted to do something with Kerbal tonight. So here I am. So let's see. Heading to vehicle assembly. First thing is, I'll show you what I'm working on tonight. I don't know if anyone hasn't seen it yet. It's the Frank Wild Memorial Fuel Depot that's going to be going in orbit around Minmus. Let's fly it. We'll show you it. Yeah, you know what, SFC? I'm sorry with that. If blame Windows Update. So I came down when the rerun should have ended because I had a good one. I had that, and then I had the new Star Trek Continues episode to go on after that. I come down, and my computer shut down. I'm like, what the heck's going on here? And so I move it, right? And it was Windows Update kicked in. You know what I mean? You know how Windows Update will come in and restart your computer for you, whether you like it or not? And I wasn't watching it. You know what I mean? I kind of set it and went to, you know, eat and all that stuff. So what happened was Windows Update must have updated Windows and shut it down. You know what I mean? Shut the computer down and restarted it. And so I apologize for that. I had every intention of running some good reruns for you. But, you know what I mean? What are you going to do, you know? So, so sorry about that. So I owe you some reruns. I owe you some reruns. Maybe I'll try the reruns again after Kerbal. Maybe I'll do that. I'll try to run them again. See what happens. So anyways, this is the Frank Wild Memorial Fuel Depot. Or the Frank Wild Depot. What I'm going to now, so what's going to happen is it's going to go in orbit around Minmus. It's got a ketane storage tank. It's got ketane processing facilities, which is going to process ketane I'm taking off of Minmus. Or Minmus. I've been told Minmus lately. I don't know why I call it Minmus, but you know, the one that looks like sherbet. Here's the nuclear reactor, nuclear engine, or nuclear electric generator, nuclear reactor. So basically, these two are going to be the fuel tanks for the station. What's going to happen is we're going to get it around in orbit around Minmus. These two are going to separate. The engines are going to separate off, which I thought about it now. I should have put a couple more propellant reactors on it, but oh well. These engines will detach. This will dock to here to this side, well, this side. This will dock here, and this will dock here. And then these will be on the end of the arms for docking ships and such. And it will be basically the refueling station around Minmus. So what I'm going to launch tonight is, hopefully, if I get them made, is the two habitation modules that's going to go there and there. And then what will happen is I'm going to dock them in curve in orbit. That way this whole thing will go out to Minmus, and all we got to do is just assemble it in orbit. But all the pieces will be there. And I got more than enough Delta V, more than enough fuel in these rockets to dock it here and get it there from here. So, that's about it. So, we're going to go work on that in the vehicle assembly building. Oh, I also have a probe I've launched that I have to get to someplace too, but I don't know where I'm going to put it yet. I don't know what plane I'm going to send it to. It was a scientific probe I launched the other night, because it was just... Well, I think I'm going to send it to Duna. But this has got to go somewhere too. I don't know if I'm going to send it somewhere tonight, but it's going to Duna, I think, pretty much. I'm going to just stick it over on Duna. It's going to be mapping Duna, things like that, using ScanSat and a Keythane detector. We're going to map. So this thing will be going to Duna. This is going to be a scanning satellite. It's going to scan for Keythane. It's going to do ScanSat stuff. All kinds of neat stuff. So, yep. So, yeah, we'll get to that. I don't know if we'll get to that tonight or not, but. Yeah. All right, so, anyways, let's get back to what we're doing. Let's get back to vehicle assembly. So what I'm going to work on tonight is or what I plan to work on now is the two habitation modules for the fuel depot. So, all right, vehicle assembly building. All right, so. Start out with that. It's not under utility. I thought it was under utility. Oh, I wasn't on the utility before. There is. Okay. Alright, there we go. That's what we wanted. So I forget what way. I think that way is up. If I remember correctly. Well, I'll figure it out when I'm going to work. Well, yeah, I'll figure it out when I'm going to work. So. All right, now we just have to build this out. Utility. I can't remember if I put a. I can't remember if I put that in there. You know what? I don't think I did. I can't remember if I put a water purifier. Hold on. Save. I don't know if I put recyclers on the station. I got to think now. I don't remember if I put recyclers on the station. Yep. I don't think I did. Honestly, I don't think I did. Hey, Treyhour, good to see ya. Hey, what's up? Good to see ya. Funny you're here. I've been doing prep for the colony mod. Well, not prep for the colony mod, but eventually to get a colony there. You haven't been here in a while. I've done a lot of stuff. You got some stuff. I haven't done a lot of stuff. You've not been here in a while. You should see what I put on Minimus to move colony segments around. Alright, did I put recyclers on this thing? I know I put some food and water on there. I don't think I did. Nope. Yeah. Unfortunately, something you have to do, right? I know. Well, good to see you. Yeah, I'll show you that. I'll show you my sky crane in a second here. I'm just checking to see if I put... Yeah, I didn't. Okay. Alright, so we'll put recyclers on there. Yeah, Treyhour, let me show you the sky crane that's going to be moving, that I put on Minimus to move, move pieces of the colony around for assembly. Oh, that's going to be a fuel depot around Minimus. Hey, Troy boy, how you doing? Good to see you. Yeah, it's going to be a fuel depot that's going to be around Minimus to refine keythane and stuff like that. The sky crane. I should have put lights up on there. Oh. This thing is what's going to move colony mods around. See, I've got an electromagnet on there. They can pick up colony pieces. And then the sky train. So what will happen is I have a lander in orbit around Kerbin I have to bring out here with a fuel truck. That's going to land here. It's going to be like a fuel truck like you see at the airport. And so this. So what will happen is I'll land the colony modules with the lander. I'll show you the lander in a minute. I'm going to land the colony modules with the lander. The sky crane will come over, pick up the piece, and then drive it over into whatever position I want to for the colony. So, and it was incredibly light to launch. In fact, it's almost too light if I didn't have keythane weighing it down. In fact, I got to put some more fuel in the top here to really weigh it down. But yep. And so this is what's going to move the mass of colony pieces around. Like a colony module only comes down halfway in here. So. More enough clearance to move stuff around. So this is where the colony is going to be right here. You know how much light this thing gives off? Look at this. Let me show you how much light this gives off. You can still see the light from it. Look. Look, I'm out as far as you can go. I'm out as far as you can go. And you can still see the light from where the colony is going to be on there. Oh, thank you. I mean, it was an idea I had in my head, and I'm like, I want to do this. I want to bring that out there. You know, I want this to have all the stuff. So, yeah, that's. I didn't realize the lights are going to be quite so bright. I mean, I can basically use it as a colony lighting. I mean, I can have the colony modules over here, park the sky crane over there, and still have lit up the area. And there's really not that many lights on there. I mean, I got like 1, 2, 3. You know, there's not that many lights, but you know, it's working. So, anyways, that's what's gonna move stuff around. This is what's gonna deliver. Oh no, I don't want to do that. I'll show you. So I have to get this out to Minimus. Still, let's go back to Kerbin. I gotta get back to Kerbin somehow. I got so much stuff around curb and I can't get it set as a focus. Oh, Colony Fuel Truck. There it is. Oh, fine, we'll switch to that and then we'll go to Colony Fuel Truck. So here, now this, I'll show you what's going to land the colony modules. I wanted something up there. Okay, so this is not what we want. So where is it? Aha! Colony Fuel Truck Launch System. So now forget about these rockets. These rockets are going to be gone. This is what's going to land the colony modules. Right here. This thing right here is what's going to land colony modules. And it's going to land them and then go back up again. And right now, I've got a colony fuel truck waiting for delivery. That's going to be a ground refueling truck. So we've got the fuel, you know, fuel tank back here, ketane tank, ketane processor, monopropellant. So this will be what fuels craft on the ground. So when a craft lands at the colony, this fuel truck will pull up. This fuel truck will pull up. A Kerbin will take the gas hose off. It's like the truck at an airport. The Kerbin will take the hose off, attach it to the spacecraft, and refuel the craft at the colony base. So like when I have ketane shuttles going up to that ketane, you know, you saw that ketane refinery, the fuel depot, that truck will refuel stuff. That's coming off the Minmus. So yeah, it's gonna be free. And this, like I said, this will stay in Minmus orbit. And I'm probably gonna dock it to that fuel station you saw, the fuel depot, and it will shuttle colony parts from the fuel depot using this thing down to the planet. So I'm getting the infrastructure ready for that colony mod. You know what I mean? But I haven't really done the colony yet. But I will at some point. But I'm gonna have all these pieces in place. This has still got to go to Minmus, though. Minmus, whatever. I keep calling Minmus, but you know what I mean. Minmus. So. I have been. You know, I get an idea in my head. And I have to make it reality. That's all the late night Kerbals you've been you've been missing. So now I'm working on the two habitation modules that are going to go on that other one. So I'm just going to dock them up in Kerbin orbit, because then the whole thing will go out together. So I'm just working on the two modules. So I don't have recyclers. I need recyclers. So we're going to set up two modules. So utility. Okay. What else do I want? All right, and I'm gonna put some monoprop on it because it's gonna have to maneuver.
that.
That. Yeah, I know it's in the way of the ladder, but you know, he's not gonna go climbing up there, whatever. Well, he might go climbing up there. I don't know. I could do it like this. I guess he could still climb. But then I lose a lateral up down. Well, no, I don't. Yeah, I'll do it that way. Oh, I almost forgot. Almost forgot. That's not what I want to play. That's what I want to play. I want to play the real deal. Even though there's no Star Trek Saturday Night tonight, I figure there should be a little Star Trek in the cast somehow. And after Kerbal tonight, there will be reruns. There will be reruns. I will not let Windows Update get to the reruns this time. I'm going to rerun Surface Tension. And I'm going to rerun the newest Star Trek Continues. Yeah, I was looking around after seeing there was this like by London Pops, but I listened to it and I didn't like it. But it just happened to have it on the last track. So this is the real deal. This is not that synth pop crap. So anyways, after this, I'm going to have the replay that I wanted to do earlier of Surface Tension from Star Trek Online. And I'm going to have the newest Star Trek Continues on after that, the Mirror Universe one. So we'll have that on after this, after I get off of Kerbal. What else do I need? I need that on the bottom. I swear hearing the soundtrack just makes me want to go watch it. Even though I've seen it a million times before, it makes me want to watch it. it's so sad. See, if I don't put a control thing on this, I'm going to have Kerbals keep going out, getting in the module, bringing it over. Do I want to do that? How much does the control... How much does it weigh? Where is it? It's control. No, it's not control. Pods. 0.5. That's a big one. 0.5.
1.1. That's a little one. Do that. Okay.
Yes, it is. Like, I know it. Like, I hear the music and I know. Yeah. So, see when you can recite con speech by heart. I used to be able to. I miss words now, but yeah. I mean, usually I'll recite con speech by heart. You know, when he's on the bridge. From hell is hot. I stab at thee. For hate's sake, I bit my last breath at thee. Oh, you won't get away, Kirk. You won't get away. Yeah. I love that stuff. Okay, utility. Yeah. Big container. 80. 40. Oh, it's on top of it. No wonder it's so high. Hopefully it can still be opened. Alright, anything I'm forgetting on that thing? I'm trying to think if there's something I'm forgetting, but I don't think there is. Oh, I know what. Okay. Kind of okay. Okay, for those. Two of those. Let's see. Close that for now. Pegasus 1. Okay. For those, couple cubic octane structs, because you never know.
Oh, I can't fit that. It's a Z100. That's a Z100, isn't it? Yeah, Z100. That's 20. That takes up 20, huh? Oh, anyway, I need to take down. Alright. RV-105 thruster block. What's that? Okay. LV bay, what the LV? The hell is that mobility? Oh, LV bay. Oh, okay, it's a ladder. So I thought, okay, it's the ladder. Okay. Oh, that's a lot of weight. Wow. I said just one, huh? All right. Radio connector port. All right. All right. Looks good. Alright, let's see if I can copy this. Nope, can't copy the whole thing. Copy this. Well, let me attach it. Will it? No, because it, no, because the attachable part's up there. We're gonna have to build it from scratch. Oh well. I had a feeling I'd have to. Alright guys, I'll be right back. Alright guys, I'll be back 1 second.
All right, I'm back.
All right, we're just going to build a copy of it down below, basically. Just a copy of it, and then what's going to happen is when this gets into orbit, they're going to separate. Like, I'm going to attach it down here with a decoupler. And when the two of these get up into space and get near the ship there, they're going to detach from each other and RCS into docking positions. You know what I mean? So, so we'll have to build it. From scratch. Okay. Should I need... battery. This. So. Like that. So now I have to, okay. I don't know, I have to put those on it. If you're wondering what that is, that's a little lifeboat mod that I found. It probably doesn't even need it. You know what? It doesn't really need it because... Let me take it off because it's not going to do any good. I'm going to need to put that. Oh no. That's on top of it, isn't it? I don't want it on top. You know, I could do this, I guess. Probably be more attractive. No. I was like, why isn't that working? There we go. Alright. I'm trying to think of everything I might need up there. Do I got a generator around there? Yeah, I got another. I could add another one of those. Let me see. I got a holotape. I got a grappling hook, electromagnet, strut endpoint. I guess nothing else. Radio Mark Parish Foundation. Oh, where are those? Can never have enough of those out there. Alright. Alright. I guess I can't think of anything else. Alright, so. Potion. Oh, I need to put things on the side of those. There we go. All right. I think that's a match. I think that's a match. All right. Not going to worry about it. Guess that's it. Guess that looks good. I'm trying to think I'm forgetting something, but I guess don't think I am. All right, start building the rocket. Oh, did I put a holo tape in there? Yeah, I did. Okay. Don't leave home without one. Right. Right. You know, whatever, good enough.
There we go. Oh, why didn't you all strut? There we go. Good enough. Oh, I've got something. Oh, hey, Treyar, I wasn't even looking over there. Power. I did forget power. I did. Good job. I did forget power. You're absolutely right. Good job. There we go. There we go. Thank you, Treyar. Thank you. See, I'm always thinking I'm forgetting something. It's like when you're walking out of the house and you're like, I know I forgot something, but I don't know what it was. I don't know what it is. I know I forgot something. But what is it? Need a little distance. That's good. No.
All right. I'm doing this wrong. Hold on. Yeah, I'm doing this wrong. No, I'm not. No, not. Yeah, I am. Yeah, I'm tired. Almost screwed that up. Almost screwed that up. Like, I'm tired right now, and I'm, like, going through my mental checklist, but my mental checklist is not exactly a great checklist right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, my checklist is not all the way complete right now, so. I'm going to asparagus this one. I'm going to asparagus. Well, as much as you can asparagus. This four, you know. Right. There we go. We do this. That way it's a generic. We should have no problem getting up with that. I'm sure we'll have fuel left over. Oh, excuse me. Is that off the ground? Right? Yeah, it's off the ground. I want to do something cool for this launch. I've always wanted to do this. I don't usually get going to this much depth, but... I think that would be cool. Raise this up a little. I don't know if you guys know what I'm doing there with those, but I'm just trying to do something cool with the... Oh, no, I don't need to. Okay, so then, And then separate. No, we gotta... Okay. Hopefully I have asparagus stages correctly. There's only four, so hopefully... Oh.
These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise.
Their ongoing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new forms and new civilizations, to boldly go.
You gotta make up for no Star Trek Saturday Night this week. I'm gonna have a nice big show next week. Big show. A really, really, really big shoe. Really, really big shoe. All about crafting. All about the new crafting system. So. Okay. I'd like to keep this in orbit, which I shouldn't have a problem keeping this. I mean, the rest of this should get it up there. Igniters, yes, that's it. That's exactly it. If they fire off like I want them to. I think with two on each side, that should look exactly the way I want it to. Yeah, I figure why not throw a little extra on there for you. You're knack and back. See, welcome back.
Alright, so I think that's all set. Is there crew on board? Because I don't think I want crew on board. Matter of fact, for sure I don't want crew on board. I wouldn't have put those remote guidance units on them. I bet you some guy snuck aboard! James T. Kerman tried to sneak on board the craft. But we got him. He's trying to steal it and fly it to the Genesis planet. Okay, I think we're all set, right? I think we're good, right? I can't think of anything else. Can't think of anything I missed. It's got lights, it's got power, it's got food, it's got water. Not that it needs food and water. I mean, it doesn't have food and water, but I brought extra for the station. It's got recyclers on it for the station. It's got everything I think we need. Somebody's still in the Enterprise. Wait a minute. It's not the Enterprise. I think my asparagus staging is okay, too. Okay. Save it. Alright, I'm going to have to launch it myself to get those to look right. If you ever do this, Kerman will never sit in a cockpit again. Alright, so what I'm going to do is, I mean, I've been getting lazy lately and letting Mechjet put them into orbit because it's just easier that way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to launch it myself because I want the igniters to go off and look cool. And then I'll let Mechjet take over the flight. So, let's get this out to the launch pad. Get this bad boy in the orbit. I got a lot of stuff that's going to go to Minimus. I got a lot of stuff going to Minimus. I got a lot of stuff. There's a lot of work I got to do. There's a lot of stuff. The Kerbal Space Program has a lot of stuff it has to do. Oh, if you're wondering what my flag is, I don't know if any of you ever wondered. I actually use my Yeti Man Gaming Channel symbol for the flag. But that's the old NASA launch flag that they used in 63, 64 and all that. That's the early NASA launch flag. Back in the 60s, they used that. So that's what that is. Okay. So I'm going to get... Oh, perfect. Okay. All right, we ready? See if I don't mess this up with the igniters on there. All right. Crew habitation modules are launching for the Frank Wild Memorial Fuel Depot in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift off. Lift off of the habitation mounts for the Frank Wild Memorial Fuel Depot. All systems look nominal at this time. We are passing through 800 meters. Engaging Mechjet. It to its orbit at 100,000 kilometers above Kerbin. Oh! Didn't want to do that. Open that up. at least I know I got the asparagus staging correct. I might have put too much delta V on this thing. I might have entirely too much delta V on this rocket. I might have overestimated the need for delta V, especially with the asparagus staging. I mean, look at her go. I don't want any space trash. I might need to manually eject that lower half. Like, I know the two engines. I know we'll get rid of those two outside engines, but that one on the bottom there, I don't have any kind of guidance system on it. So I can't get rid of it, and I don't want there to be space trash. Really? We'll stop rotation? Really? Wow. When is point 24? I'm thinking this week, but I don't know. I just don't like the money part of it. The only part I don't like is like the money part. I don't want to have to use money. I like science as a currency. You know, that's so cool that science is the currency to unlock. You know, or like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I understand career, they're trying to do a career mode, but I guess I'm not a big restriction guy. Or I don't know. You know what I'm trying to say? I think I put entirely, maybe too much delta V on this thing. I don't know. We're going to find out. Once you set, well, oh, wow. I way over delta. Yeah, I got way over. I think. Yeah, I way over delta. I put way too much fuel on this thing. There's no way I'm going to burn off that upper stage. What is the burn? Because it's not going to be a big, it's not going to be a big burn at all to get into orbit. Let's shut off auto warp. Oh, I mean, geez, look at that. So I brought about 2,300 more delta V than I actually needed. Right on the money. That is true. That is true, Trail, because they will show it off first. You're absolutely right about that. They will preview it. They'll let them have a chance to preview it. You know, all the streamers on there will get a copy, and they'll preview it, and they'll do the career mode, you know, with the money and everything, and then it'll be released. Yeah, you're absolutely right about that. So maybe not next week, the week after. That's probably more reasonable. Estimated burn in 3 minutes, 1 second. What's the estimated burn? 262. Which would leave 1,700 delta V, which is more than enough. So what we're going to do is I'm going to manually stage this. There we go. So we're going to do that. Because I hate space trash. I really hate space trash. So. Alright, T-Mac Jabba, do your thing, ding-a-ling. That turned out to be a real nice launch vehicle. Just what we needed. Dink. It's all set. Well, you didn't put me into a perfect orbit. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you, MacJab? No. Let there be light! And there was light. Alright. So 1704. It'd be cool if it was 1701. Get it? 1701? No. Yeah. Alright, what else do I got for... let's just go into the Kerbal queue. My Kerbal playlist. Oh, here we go. I wish I could find... You know, I love to play the Apollo 13's soundtrack. But I can't ever find anywhere, and I don't feel like buying it. You know what I mean? That's an Enterprise. Good one, SFC. Good one. Well, I guess now we should start trekking... to the rest of the fuel depot. Where is it? How close am I? I'm pretty close. No, that's doing a probe launch vehicle. Where is it? Drink wild fruit and fuel depot. So what do we need? I don't know if I want to let MechJeb do it, but... Oh, you know what? Before I do any of that... Before I let MechJeb do anything, we're gonna quick save this, because not that I don't trust MechJeb, I just don't trust MechJeb. I just don't trust him. I wish I could trust him, but sometimes he does some weird, crazy things, you know. So. Let's see. What is that? Oh, that's the one thing of debris I have in orbit. I gotta go grab that thing and knock it out of the sky. I gotta get that stuff someday. That bugs me. That's my one debris I have. So. Target. How close? 20 meters. 25 meters. Alright, let's see what it does. Matching planes, you should be the exact same plane. What are you doing? That's one more pun stream. You know, I've thought about the idea of doing 12 hours of Kerbal. Can you imagine 12 hours of Kerbal? 12 hours of Kerbal. That'd be so. I could probably do 12 hours of Kerbal. I don't think I'll be doing another 12-hour stream for a while, though. You know, I thought about it last night, and I appreciate everybody who tuned in. You know I do. I mean, I know you were there, SFC, and I appreciate everybody who was tuning in. Chris was there, and, you know, Totally Twitch. A lot of other people were there, and that's great, and I appreciate that. But I kind of do the 12-hour stream. Now, I enjoyed playing the game for 12 hours. I like Dark Souls 2. But you also hope that you're going to get a few viewers out of it. You know, I mean, to be honest. And we just, the 12-hour stream, whether I stream 5 or 12 hours, it, you know, it's pretty much about the same, so. And the 12-hour stream just killed me for my whole schedule. Yes, yes, I know, Galaxy Quest. That's a good movie. I mean, I don't know, I think that's a good movie. I like Galaxy Quest. I think it's well done. No, it's okay, SFC. I didn't expect you to. No. What the 12-hour streams are supposed to do, or what I wanted them to do, was to bring in new viewers. You know, we have our base, which is great, and you guys are great, and they watch everything, but it's to try and bring in new viewers. And it seems like they don't bring in any more. It seems like when I do a 12-hour stream, it doesn't bring in any more new viewers than a regular stream does. So then if that's the case, why do a 12-hour stream? Because it knocks me out of whack. You know, it knocks my whole equilibrium out of whack and everything. Like today, I'm all kind of tired because I couldn't fall asleep this morning. I was so Dark Souls 2 psyched up, you know what I mean, that I couldn't fall asleep, so I ended up staying up more than, you know, whatever. So I was really up like 24 hours if you consider I was up all day yesterday doing just regular life stuff, and then I did my 12 hours, and so. So again, I hope you guys understand what I'm saying. It's not that I didn't have fun playing the game, because I had a lot of fun. I enjoyed the game. I enjoyed everybody who was in there, all that stuff. But it's just that, like I said, I could do a 4 or 5 hour stream and have as many people watch, and new people watch as a 12-hour stream, and it doesn't screw me up as much. So I'm debating whether or not to do another 12-hour stream, because that's like the fourth one I've done, third or fourth one. I think the fourth one. And, you know, they just don't, they're not any more than a regular stream is, so, you know. So, but you know, guy, you know, I'm honest with you guys. I'm just, you know, I'm just speaking what's in my head. I wouldn't lie to you guys. I have too much respect for you. Yeah, and I mean, that's what I'm saying, SFC. It seems like a 5-hour stream or a 12-hour stream or a 6-hour stream, it doesn't matter how long the stream is. So why throw myself off equilibrium-wise and all that other stuff? You know what I mean? So. Oh. Although I'm itching to play some more Dark Souls 2. I really am. I want to go actually, what I'm itching to do is farm some souls from those giants there, so I can raise up my stamina a little more. I really like that game, but it's a time sink. It's a time sink. Now, it's taken an hour. It's taken an hour for this for Metro to do a rendezvous. I would have already done it by now. This is why I only use Mechja for certain things, if at all. Like, getting a ship to orbit is kind of hard for Mechja to screw up. I mean, it can screw it up, but it's kind of hard. But, like, why did you need to bring the entire orbit out to 212 kilometers? I don't get it. Like, just bring it out. Whatever. Oh, SFC. Marvel Heroes is a wonderful game. It's an awesome game. It really is. It really is. It's a wonderful game. I can't recommend it high enough, Marvel Heroes. And I'm trying to, and that's the thing. I try and have a variety of games on here, because I don't want to just be Marvel Heroes. And to be honest with you, I guess one of the Marvel Heroes streamers, I'm really not one of the top. I mean, I don't get, if I got, I mean, we get our core people who watch Marvel Heroes, and that's great, but that doesn't grow at all. So that's why I like to have a variety in the games, because I want, you know, to try and have something for everybody. So. And be games that I like. That's why I like the console gaming. That's why I really like playing these console games that I play, like, on Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays. I don't know. Maybe it hurts the channel. I don't know. Maybe I should play Marvel Heroes all the time, or this and that, right? But I like the fact that we play Marvel Heroes on, like, Saturday and Monday. We play Marvel Heroes. Sunday, we have Euro Truck. And then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday for the summer, we have console games. You know, I like that. And plus, I gotta say that, you know, with Marvel Heroes, you know, I pretty much get slammed on some of the other days with some of the other, you know. And that's fine. I mean, hey, you know, they're, I'm sure, better than I am. But, so, you know, I love Marvel Heroes, so it's always going to have a place in the schedule, but I like variety, too. I like variety. Like, I'll get burned out if I play one game all the time. So, that's why I try and have something for everybody. I try and have a little Star Trek, because I love Star Trek. I try and have Kerbal, because I love Kerbal. Euro Truck, I love Euro Truck. Console games, so we can have something different every week. Like, we just had all those Uncharted we played through. So... You know, all that stuff. So. But I'm just blah, 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 blah. Just trying to tell you guys where I'm coming from. I get in a whole discussion. Just trying to give you an idea of where the channel's going or where the channel's at or where it's at. So, yeah. So, anyways, this Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and probably Friday, too. Maybe not Thursday, because I can't really use my console on Thursday for reasons I can't get into. But I can't use the software. But Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday next week, we're going to be playing Dark Souls 2. And then I think the week after, as much as I can sit here and play Dark Souls 2 forever on the cast, I might move into another game, which I'm thinking I want to do Hitman. I'm thinking of playing Hitman Blood. And then once Hitman Blood Money's done, starting with the new Hitman game, was it Absolution? Because I haven't played through that yet. So I'm thinking after next week. Next week's going to be Dark Souls. And then the week after, we're going to start in a Hitman week. Because I really want to go through the Hitman waves games again. And I loved Hitman Blood Money when it came out. I played that game. I was like, oh, I love this game. I loved all the different ways you could, you know, assassinate and stuff like that. So, Yep. So, I think the week after next is going to be Hitman. We're going to start Hitman stuff. Well, it's at 250% XP, too. That's not hurting people either, SFC. That's not hurting people either. That is not hurting people either. You know what I'm saying? I mean, that's pretty good. If I was smart, I'd probably be playing Marvel Heroes right now, but I just feel like doing some Kerbal, so... Gotta go with what you feel like. And I know you guys like seeing the late night Kerbal, so, you know, it's a win-win. Oh, can you just get me there, please? Wow, it's gonna stop on a dime. It's gonna like, oh, there's the sun. I'm blinded. It's gonna stop on a dime. Mr. Fantastic looks wicked cool, doesn't he, SFC? I was looking at him today, you know, and the people playing him. He looks wicked cool. Oh, we're getting a little bit of a park count here, apparently. Apparently we're having a park count. Okay. It's always at 2.3 kilometers. If you notice when you watch my stream, when the ship gets 2.3 kilometers close, that's when you start to have physics. That's when all the physics tries to catch up to everything else. I'll give extra credit. It took a long time, but It's getting there. Oh, yeah. DS9 is... that's next to the original series, that's my favorite. Love Deep Space Nine. I might bring my Defiant class out of retirement. I don't know. I might want to get that up and working again. Maybe that'll be a thing I want to do. Now, you're just going to RCS this over, I would imagine. Are you going to pump... Are they gonna? Is he gonna pump the main lines, or is he gonna just RCS it? Probably gonna pump the fuel. It's a 0.5 burn. Yeah. Okay. He's doing that. Yeah. He's just. Just a little bit on the thrust. I see. I would have used RCS here, but that's fine. That's fine. He's saving my RCS. I would have, you know. Okay, so I didn't have to do anything. I could just sit here and talk to you guys and watch MechJeb do this. But MechJeb took way longer to get this rendezvous than it would have taken me. I would have been there a lot shorter. I probably would have been there about 5 minutes ago. But MechJeb is very methodical because it's a machine, you know, it's a but I'm just sitting here like a Captain Dunsel, letting it do all the work, letting the M5 bring us closer to the station.
M5, murder is a breaking of God and man's moral laws.
This unit must preserve itself.
Of course, but not at the expense of human life.
Jim, I think he's losing it. Oh, Traer, no doubt. I mean, MechJeb used to have some real weird things going on. I mean, it's doing what's supposed to. I remember when MechJeb didn't even do what you wanted it to do. You know what I'm saying? It couldn't even figure out, it would just not do what you wanted it to do. So don't get me wrong, it's doing what it's supposed to do. It just, it takes it longer than a person does. You know what I mean? I mean, it does do what it's supposed to do. But it just takes it a little bit longer. That's all. I like the orbit. The best thing about it is, and I don't use it that often. I'm using it more now because I've just, whatever, it's there and I may as well use it. It's great getting a ship into orbit. Especially... something that's kind of unwieldy, because then you don't have to do the work. Like getting that sky crane up into orbit, oh my god. I was constantly I had the RCS jets on, and I was constantly adjusting that, because that was not, as you can tell, that was not aerodynamically sound. That was not, you know. Now see, I would have time warped through this, but it's going to just go normal speed. I have not used it until lately, honestly. I have not used it for months now. Because I do it all myself. But now I'm just trying to let it do stuff for me. You know, like I'm letting it do stuff for me now. But I know I can do all of it myself, so I don't feel bad. So. So I don't feel too whatever about it. Yeah, it is. It is a big project. They're all big projects. I don't do anything but big projects, it seems like. I don't do anything but big. Oh, excuse me. I don't like simple. I guess. I don't like simple. But I'm not trying to do one thing. I'm trying to do like five different things with something. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to do just one thing. I'm trying to... So if like I send a mission to Duna right now, I'm going to have a... What I'm going to do is I'm going to... So like my mission to Duna, right? I have the KSS Hotspur, which is that cruiser. So what I'll do is I'll send out a big rover ahead of time, a big giant rover ahead of time, that will land on the surface of Duna. Or it'll be on orbit around Duna. This is going to be my Duna profile so far that I've got. I'm going to land a giant rover out to Duna, put it in orbit. The Hotspur will dock with it. transfer crew onto the rover. The rover will land on Duna, and it will be able to do extended scientific exploration of the planet in the rover, a mobile scientific laboratory. Then when it's time to go, there will be a craft on the rover that can launch off of the rover, like a little tiny craft, like, you know, almost like you think of the moon mission, that will launch off the rover, dock with the Fiend, dock with the Hotspur. The Hotspur will come back. The rover will stay on the surface because I will have a remote thing on it, and it will continue to travel around and stuff. While the Hotspur returns with the crew and the science. So, you know, like, I'm not going to just send someone in a little capsule, you know what I mean, to just land and then come back and all that. No, I'm going to build, like, you know what I mean, like a NASA thing. Like, I'm not going to, and I'm going to bring a make sure I have more food, more water, more whatever than I probably need, but because I want a safety margin. Now, see, are you going to stop? See? See what I mean about Mech Jeb? Maybe it would have fired. Maybe it would have fired, but I don't know if I trust it. All right. I should have fired the RCS a little more. All right. All right, I think that stopped me. Yes. Okay. I'm gonna slide on by, I think. All right. All right, let's quick save that. Yeah, it will be nice. Yeah, Trey, you're right. It will be. Hey, Hunter, how you doing tonight? Good to see you. Okay. Now, we're going to see if Mech Jeb can dock one of these bad boys. Now, did I just quick save it? I did, didn't I? Yeah. Right? Let me check. I'm going to do that again because I can't remember. All right, so we're going to dock one of these bad boys here, and hopefully it doesn't hit the panel. Because I can't close those things, so hopefully. I mean, I could probably do it myself, but. All right. Undock the first. All right. Let us. Figure out where am I firing at?
up, down. Okay. All right, so we need to turn the RCS off. Turn that off. Maybe I'll do this docking myself. But maybe I'll do this docking myself. I forget, guys. Do you remember, is the door in the top or the bottom? Does anybody remember? I want to say the door is on the top if you want to have it right side up looking out. Because this is the bottom and the microwave transmitter is the top. So I think that's how I want it. Maybe I should have brought a Kerbal with me. All right. Trying to figure out my equilibrium here. Yep. All right, right there. I might screw this up. Oh God, I am not straight, am I? Shoot. Alright. God, what is slowing down? I need to go up. Pretty good music for this, isn't it? Lined up right. No. No. Right there. Would have been cool if it docked right at the end of that music. Hey, Rogue Ice, how you doing? Hey, good to see ya. Don't look like it's gonna be right, but I guess it is. Oh, too much. Come on. We have a dock. We have a hard dock. Habitation module number one is docked with the station. Whew. Where's the rest of it? Right there. Just sitting right off there. Ah, let's F5 that bad boy. Woohoo. All right. That would be actually a pretty cool interplanetary cruiser in a way, if you think about it, with the microwave. That would be pretty good. I mean, I got about... Well, if I didn't add that to it. Let's say I just added that to it, and that was it. That would be a pretty cool cruiser, huh? That would be a pretty cool cruiser. That could... Yeah, that would be... We have a hard time soon. Driving to Venice anytime soon. No, I wasn't thinking about that. I wasn't thinking about driving to Venice anytime soon. No, I wasn't. Nope. I was not. Nope. My car has trouble underwater. The Yeti Mobile is not waterproof. All right. Well, now that I have a free... Did I quick save? I'm paranoid. I'm going to quick save again. All right, let's get the other module docked. And then everything will be there for Minimus. And then everything will be there, Minimus. This is perfect music for this docking stuff. I mean, this is, like, just the best... Oh, okay. So, for this part... where's my stage? Oh, it's staging. This is going to be kind of tricky because I have to eject it. So this should be interesting. It didn't fire. Here we go. Beautiful. Oh, that's fine. That wasn't that much force. Am I missing something? What do you mean no beta action in a Euro Truck Simulator? What? What do you mean? I have no idea, Rogue.
World Geist. What? Am I missing something? I'm going to Mother Russia tomorrow. I'm going to Mother Russia tomorrow. Actually, I'm already in Mother Russia. But what? What? You mean, is it? Are you talking about Venice Beach or something? Is there like American Truck Simulator beta I don't know about or something? But oh, I didn't know that. It's in beta? No, I didn't get a beta invite. Nobody invited me to beta. But, you know, it's just little old me. Little old me Yeti. They're like, who is that man? I don't know who that is. Like, we don't know who he is. Euro Truck Sunday Convoy? What's a Euro Truck Sunday Convoy? We need to get you on the other side. It's a public beta. I still haven't. Where did you get it from, Steam? Oh, wait a minute. I don't know if I should try a beta. With all the mods and everything I have. Who knows? Beta could just... Is this something you sign up for on Steam, or do you have to go to the website? Actually, you know what? I want to go back into docking. Yep, should be an announcement on Steam. We are having an issue in the open beta that now is not available on Steam because of the public beta. I'll have to look for that. I'll look for that, Rogue Guys. I will look for that. Tomorrow, I got to say, though, I'm very much looking forward to the Mother Russia map. It took me a while on last week's to get into Mother Russia, but I bought two garages in Brest, and I forget what the other place is. So now we're going to be trucking it to Moscow and all those other cities. It takes a while to get to Moscow. It's kind of far away, but we should be able to make it there tomorrow. I'm a little down. Nope. I gotta need to give us Punishers. Hey, cool. I gotta try Punisher. Especially with that beautiful, that great costume he got. I don't know if this is the music I want for a docking. Just thinking about that. This might not be the music I want.
No, I don't want sticky keys. I hate that. Don't you hate that when you're playing Kerbal and you're pressing a key and it was, it gives you that sticky key message? God, I hate that. Oh, very good buy, Rogue Ice. Very good eye. Very good buy. I love the Morrowind series. It's almost too big. Like, I could, like, I gotta finish my Skyrim playthrough. But that'll take me forever, because I go, like, those games, I go, like, every nook and cranny and everything. It's ridiculous. Which mono prop am I actually using? God, I'm hardly using any. This reminds me of those pods in Star Trek The Motion Picture. Wait, no, other way. Other way. Back to docking, let's see if I can figure this out. Oh, I got what I gotta do. Yes, slow down. Okay. All right, now. All right. Back to docking. I gotta figure out where everything's firing. Thank you. Oh, it's playing it again, isn't it?